Hi, we're the Tones of Faith, and we really appreciate WLJC. They've really been good to us. It's a real good church for those who cannot go to church. We really, really, really appreciate this television station for going out and spreading the word to the lost in a dying world, because they really need to hear. They really need to hear the gospel, and you will hear it here at WLJC.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to the service tonight. We really hope that you'll stay with us. We have a good group that has come to fill in for us tonight and to bless you with their music. And so we want you to join in with us as we sing and talk about the Lord and just worship Him from wherever we are. And you know, as we do this, it can all go up to heaven as one praise to the Lord. If we're praising Him, regardless of where you are, we can all praise the Lord at one time. So we welcome each of you to stay with us. And we have some good scripture here tonight that I want to share with you, because this is something that honestly you hear a lot of hand-me-down religious sounding things that is not from the Bible. It's a part of a quote that somebody quoted to somebody way two or three generations back, and we just get bits and pieces. Well, we need to know what the Word says. And so this chapter tonight that I'm going to read is about true love. You hear about people falling in love and falling out and all this stuff. Well, this is about true love. And 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, it says, "Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels and have not charity or love, I am becoming as sounding brass or tinkling cymbals. And though I have the gift of prophecy and could understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains and have not charity or love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, and have not charity or love, it profiteth me nothing. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity or love envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up," talking about true love, "doth not behave itself unseemingly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth, beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Charity or love never faileth. But whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, and have not that which is perfect to come. Then that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child, understood as a child, I thought as a child, and when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, and then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as also I am known. And now abideth faith, hope, charity, or love, these three, but the greatest of these is charity or love." And you know, it's saying when we're kids, you know, children understands like a child. But as they get older, well, then they gain more knowledge and more about everything. And so they change. And so That's the way it is. We get just a little bit. We understand about the fullness of love and what it really means here. But then when we get to go to heaven, then we'll really understand what love was all about, what the love that Christ had for us. He did not have to go to the cross. No one made him, but he did because he loved us. Now, this is the kind of love that we're talking about. But just remember, love never fails. But the greatest of faith, hope, and charity, but the greatest is charity. So if you want to pattern your life after what Jesus wants us to be like, then read 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. It's the 13th chapter. It has 13 verses. And so there it tells us about love and how it never fails. And you know, how it does not rejoice in iniquity, but it rejoiceth in truth. You know, when you hear gossip or bad things happening to people, and if you rejoice, then it just tells one thing on you. You don't have the love of God in your heart, or you would not be rejoicing at someone else's failure or somebody's fall or misfortune or whatever came their way. If you rejoice in it, that means that the love of God is not in your heart, and you're telling on yourself, because out of your mouth, from your heart, the mouth speaketh. So all the good things we could do, but if we don't have love, it doesn't matter. It doesn't make any difference. It will not amount to anything. So that's 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. So I hope that you can read it, and with an open mind, ask God to help you to understand how much of this love, this kind of real, true love that we need. Every family needs it. Every individual needs it. And if a lot of marriages, they had some of this kind of love instead of this, the romantic kind, things would go a lot better. They'd be kind to each other, and there wouldn't be a lot of fussing and fighting going on, because there would be actual love and respect for each other. And you know, you think about people getting married, here comes the summer months when there's so many weddings and everything. And I always think, do they know enough about how to love each other and make a go of it? They can be happy if they choose to. If each of them treats the other one with respect and does not do what things to hurt the other one, they'll be happy. So I pray for some of these marriages that are coming up. Because we like to see them succeed. We like to see them make a go of it, because they have true kind of love in their heart. Well, let's see. Before we pray, I want to mention some things here. A lady has called for her pregnant daughter and says they don't have a good relationship, having trouble with the neighbors also, for the caller and the whole family. All right. And then Cynthia Childers, she is under hospice care right now and needs a special touch from the Lord. A young man at UK Hospital, Alan May, is in need of help. And then we have this email prayer request came to us from North Carolina. This lady is having trouble because her kidneys have shut down. It's been like over a week, and she's getting in really bad shape mentally and physically, and said she's becoming suicidal and about to have a nervous break, and she's saying, help, 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 I'm freaking out. And so she wanted us to pray for her. She does not give what her age is or anything other than her physical condition. So I want you to help us to pray for this lady and her kidneys tonight. So she needs we don't know how God's going to answer, but we do believe that when we pray in agreement that he knows how. We were just talking tonight in my office about some of the things that God has, how he's answered prayers lately. When you ask and pray for people to be delivered, then God doesn't stand there and wait for us to get through and say, well, now tell me how to do this. No, he doesn't do that. God knows how we're made up, because He created us, remember? He knows what makes us tick. He knows when we need physical help, or He knows when we need spiritual help or financial help or whatever. He knows how. And so our part is to ask and to leave it with Him and let Him choose the avenue that is needed to bring healing to these people. And so here's this one young man fighting for his life, and this lady, and these two, Cynthia and others, that we just need to pray and give them to the Lord. So help me do that right now. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank You that we have You to come to. We thank You, Lord, that we know You are our source. You are the where we get our help. And so for these that have asked for prayer, Lord, we thank You for their faith and that they know that You are a God, a prayer-answering God. And so we ask for healing to be brought to each one of these individuals that we've mentioned and all the others that will be tuning in tonight. Lord, give them the healing that is needed. Bless our guests and the phone operators, and Lord, help us some way, somehow, reach someone tonight with the good news of the gospel. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, tonight we're happy to have Mercy Roadz with us from Berea. Now, we had another group scheduled, and for different reasons, they could not make it. We called these folk, and they were willing to come on the spur of the moment and to fill in for them. And I like people that, you know, can do this. Not everyone can, because, you know, a lot of times people have to make arrangements ahead of time. But Mercy Roadz from Berea, Kentucky, and they have a new CD that's coming right along. It won't be long till you'll be able to purchase a new CD from them. And call 859-200-2065. Is that right? Did I give somebody else's? Okay. And they'll give you their email and so forth there. And so let's welcome right now Mercy Roadz.
Well, I've been a soldier in God's mighty army since many long years ago. And I've been scarred and wounded in battle, and many times I've been brought low. But by the signs of the times, I then realize I've only one more mile to go. Well, is that the lights of heaven up above? I feel like running my last mile home. Yes, I feel like running my last mile. Feel like running my last mile home. Well, Jesus said when He reached down and saved me, I'll go with You all the way. So I stepped out on His precious promise, and it filled me both night and day. I know it's been many years, but I still can feel the Spirit moving in my soul. Well, it gives me just a taste of what lies ahead. I feel like running my last mile home. Yes, I feel like running my last mile home. Yes, I feel like running my last mile home. I see a great band of angels round God's throne. Oh, what a great celebration. While ages roll on, I feel like running my last mile home. Feel like running my last mile home.
Hey, hallelujah. I feel like running my last mile home. I'm glad to be here tonight. But Sister Margaret, it's such an honor to be able to serve God in this manner. This is a wonderful, wonderful ministry here today. And I know there's people out there today, Sister Margaret, that old crystal mess got a hold of them. But let me tell you something. I was on it for 5 years, and the Lord delivered me from it. I don't need it anymore. And I'm standing here a healthy man because of the hand of God. Hallelujah. I'm so thankful. Sister, they said that you need to give them the email address. Give them your email address.
It's lizgabbert49@yahoo.com. This goes out to all our friends in Paint Lick and Wildy post offices. I work at the post office, so. Troubles and trials in my little lifespan. When I'm alone and the battle is hot, I always do the best that I can. Must have shed a million valleys, must have shed a million tears. I will have no fear. One more mountain, one more mountain to climb. One more valley that I gotta go through, and I'm leaving my troubles behind. One more. Then I know he'll understand. I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah, holding to his nails for hand. Been a lot of people talking about me since I walked this narrow way. Well, that's just another little valley I came through when I prayed. Climbed a lot of high mountains, crossed a lot of little streams. When I see old Jordan Cotendorf, that'd be the last for me. One more river to cross, one more mountain to climb, one more valley that I gotta go through, and I'm leaving my troubles behind. One more battle with the devil, then no, he'll understand. I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah, holding to his nails grown hand. One more river to cross, one more mountain to climb, one more valley that I gotta go through, and I'm leaving my troubles behind. One more battle with the devil, then I know he'll understand. I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah, holding to his nails grown hand. I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah, holding to his nails scarred hand.
I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah. I'm so thankful tonight to have a Jesus to reach out to grab a hold of. He's blessed me so much. He's brought us through a whole lot, Eddie, Brother Ernie.
Man, that's right.
Oh, hallelujah.
So
against you. My Father is greater. My brother is the Savior. I'm hanging out with the mighty rushing wind. Some folks think it's really strange when I talk about my life. Although this world has been crazy, I got no troubles, I got no strife. I'm on the inside to the freedom, and I'm living in the light. But didn't I mention my Father is greater, my brother is the Savior. I've been born again.
Hallelujah, I'm born again. You know, it's good to be a born again child of God tonight. He said today is the day of salvation, Brother Ernie.
Amen.
Today is the day. And today, if you don't know Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, dial that number that's on the screen. Talk to these folks up here in the prayer room. They'll pray with you. It's so simple. It's so easy. All you have to do is just ask him to come in. Oh, hallelujah. Are you ready?
I'd like to send this out to my wife and my two sisters, Helen Rice and Jean Boone and family. I hope they get a blessing out of this.
We missed you in church last Sunday, but we all said a prayer for you. Each face was all smiles last Sunday, and what a blessing, and each song we sang. Did you have other plans? Were you too busy? Oh, where were you when the church bells rang? We miss you. Was there something to do? We missed you in church last Sunday, but we all said a prayer for you. You missed a great sermon last Sunday, and best of all, a lost soul was saved.
We miss you in church last Sunday. Were you sick? Was there something to do? We missed you in church last Sunday. But we all said a prayer for you. But we all said a prayer for you. I was standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day when I saw that hearse come rolling for to carry my mother away. Oh, will a circle be unbroken? Undertaker, Undertaker, please drive slow. That body you're hauling, Lord, I hate to see her go. Will a circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better all waiting in the sky. Well, I followed close behind them, tried to hold up and be brave, but I could not hide my sorrow as they laid her in that grave. Will a circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better back home, Lord, I was lonely since my mother, she has gone. All my brothers, sisters crying, what a home, all so sad and alone. Will a circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home waiting in the sky. There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Oh, hallelujah, got a better home awaiting in the sky. He said he went to build us a mate. We've got mansions, streets of gold, cities of gold. But most of all, we can walk hand in hand with the Lord that saved our souls and laid his life down for us, sis. He laid his life down and didn't have to pay the debt. He didn't know that we could be set free, Brother Dog, from the sin of this world. Hallelujah.
Oh,
You know, I feel like there's a lot of people out there that's hurt and confused. They say, well, my bills are overtaking me. You may be on drugs. You may have lost a loved one. You may be in deep depression. But how many knows there's somebody out there called Jesus? He can take away the pain. He can help you if you just cry out to him. He's a way maker. He said he'd be your doctor. He'll be your lawyer. He'll be everything that you need. If you have Jesus, you have everything. Just pray for me. There's somebody out there hurt and confused, an innocent child being abused. There's somebody out there whose heart is breaking into. Somebody out there feeling alone, a husband, a wife being done wrong. There's somebody out there shattered from a broken home. But there's somebody out there, thumbs open wide, who longs to embrace you. Wipe the tears from your eyes. So full of hopeless, you'll carry the burden you bear. When you don't have a prayer, there's somebody out there. There's somebody out there thought it was cool to keep taking chances, thinking they'd never lose. Now they're hooked on a feeling that's left them empty and full. There's somebody out there can't quite decide whether to live, whether to die. Searching for strength to get through their crisis in life. But there's somebody out there, thumbs open wide, who longs to embrace you. Wipe the tears from your eyes. It's hope for the hopeless. You'll carry. There's somebody out there. And there's somebody out there, thumbs open wide, who longs to embrace you. Wipe the tears from your eyes. So for the hopeless, you'll carry the burden you bear. When you don't have a prayer, there's somebody out there. Jesus is his name. He's that someone out there. Jesus is his name. He's that someone out there.
Living my life in flight. He's got enough love to go around for all of us. God loves each and every one the same. He's no respecter of persons. I'm thankful tonight that he loved me enough that he picked me up out of the mud and the mire and the nastiness and cleaned me off tonight. I'm thankful tonight that he stood me up on my feet, sis, and let me walk again and let me live again. Hallelujah.
Send this one out to Mr. and Mrs. Bill and Darlene Cromer, my neighbor there. Real good neighbors, and they love this song, and I hope they get a blessing out of it. Would you send your best angel for my mama? I don't. Call my mama, would you please take special care with her? And dear Lord, would you let her die easy? For she has suffered so much here on this earth.
Would you send your best angel for my mama? I don't want her to make this journey here alone. Would you send the same one you sent for Daddy? And I know she'll be a perfect angel, for she has been a perfect mama to me. And when it's time for me to come and join them, would you send that same angel for me? Would you send your best angel for my mama? I don't want her to make this journey all alone. Would you send the same one you sent for Daddy to make sure that my mama makes it home, and to make sure that my mama makes it home?
Why don't you swing that church stop and let me ride now? Swing that church stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, all that easy. I got a home on the other side. Lazy cool went down in the middle of a field. Said he saw an angel with a chariot wheel. Weren't too particular about no chariot wheel. Just wanted to know how old Jerry would feel. Why don't you swing that Jerry stop and let me ride? Swing that Jerry stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, calm and easy. I got a home on the other side. Ezekiel went down and he got on board. Went a bumpin' down a bumpy road. Zeke didn't care about no bumpin' of road. Just wanted to lay down his heavy load. Why don't you swing that chair stop and let me ride? Swing that chair stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, calm and easy. I got home. Thank you. Well, I got a father in the promised land. I ain't a stop until I shake his hand. Rock me, Lord, call that easy. I got home on the other side. Why don't you swing that church stop and let me ride? Swing that church stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, call that easy. I got a home on the other side. Yes, I got a home on the other side. Hallelujah! I got a home on the other side. I get excited just thinking about where I'm going to glory.
Some great music, and we're going to give them just a little break. And now, some of them are not feeling too well. The Lord brought them through a bad accident, a car accident. They might tell you about that a little later, but the hand of the Lord was with them, and they're still able to sing and play tonight. So if they want to get them a drink of water, you've been listening to Mercy Roadz from Berea, Kentucky. Now, they were on their way to do a recording when the accident happened, so I guess it will mean it'll be twice as good when you get there, so coming through that many trials. But God's hand is with us. Now, I had a 16-year-old great-granddaughter that had rolled her car 3 times the other day, but she's on the gravel road and going too fast, and you know how teenagers are, but I believe she's a better driver tonight because she's sure to get her seat belt on, which she had on that night. But then after the car rolling, her cell phone happened to be within reach so that she could call 911. It wouldn't reach any other number. But God is merciful. So he was with these men as they had the accident. And they might want to tell you a little about it, but they will be having some new CDs in just a very short time, a few weeks. Give them a little time to get all the finishing details on it. But if you'd like to call this group and schedule them to come your way, it's 859-200-2065, Mercy Roadz. And they're from the Rose Hill Church at Mount Vernon, Kentucky. Mount Vernon. All right. Well, we really appreciate them coming tonight on a short notice and bringing their equipment and so forth. And you know, life is very precious. We never know. You've seen a lot of mottos said, we don't know what tomorrow holds, but we know who holds tomorrow. And that is true. And the Lord's told us not to worry and get in a hurry about worrying about tomorrow and all the things it can bring, because sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. In other words, if we take care of today and not sin against the Lord, then tomorrow, you know, he'll give us grace for another day. And so he knows our heart. He wants us to be at our best for him, because we only get one shot at this, you know, only one time we're going through this life. And some days you say, thank you, Lord, that it's only one. I'm glad he doesn't make people live to be like Methuselah so many hundreds of years. That would be rough. But he gives us enough time to get to know him, accept him as our personal Savior, and to share with others the good news. The good news is that God loves you and Jesus died for you, and this doesn't change. The daily news changes, our lives and circumstances change. Now, anytime they want to come back, well, it'll be fine, but I wanted to give them a little break. But just remember, life is precious, and we're supposed to handle it with much prayer, because we don't know what tomorrow might bring, but we know that the Lord will be with us, because he's promised to be with us all the way to the very end. And so this group tonight, if you would like to have their CDs, I'm going to jot down this number and 859-200-2065. And I'm sure they have a lot of songs we haven't got to hear yet. And they also have a church over there you might want to go and attend. And but they're back ready to sing for us, and we appreciate that. So let's return to the Mercy Roadz.
Glory, hallelujah. I want to send this next song out to our church family out of Rose Hill Church. And I want to let them know about how much we love them and how much we appreciate them and everything that they do for us. You know, we are blessed. I've seen churches that couldn't get nobody to pick up a piece of paper, but we've got people there that you don't even have to ask them. They just have to do it. It's the love of God in that little church.
Preacher man preached about God's like on Jesus, said it would set me free. Well, I sat for a minute or two, then I finally got off my pew and at the altar. It's when I hit my knees in these streams of mercy.
Lying on his deathbed, fighting for his love,
Jesus said, I'm sorry, as we gather by his side. So I took him by the hand to say my last goodbye. When a frail and feeble voice spoke up and gave me this reply. You can't tell me I'm dead.
You know, a lot of people think that death is the end. But when you know Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, death is just the beginning. He said to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. And when you're saved and you're sanctified and you're standing holy before God, you've got a place to go. The soul is going to go on to be with the Lord. You know, sis, there's times that I can't get out of bed unless God's right there with me. He has to be right there. I can't get out of bed. I can't open my eyes. I can't breathe without him. I can't live without him. There was a time in my life, Sister Margaret, I thought I could do it all. But I found out that I was in quicksand. I was ready to die. McCarl, would you? I thought number one would always be me. I thought I could be what I wanted to be. But I thought I could build on life's sinking sands. But I can't even walk without you holding my hands. I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountain's too high, the valley's too wide. Now down on my knees, that's where I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I thought I could do a lot on my own. I thought I could make it all alone. I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't even walk without you holding my hands. I can't even walk without you holding my hands. The mountain's too high, or the valley's too wide. Now down on my knees, that's where I that I've got a Jesus to hold my hand while I go through the storms and the trials. I think I'll make Jesus my all in all. When I'm in trouble, on his name I will call. I don't trust in him, I'd be less of a man. Lord, I can't even walk
without you holding my hand. I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountain's too high, the valley is too high. Where I learned to stand. No, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. No, I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
I can't walk without him holding my hand. You know, Brother Don, sometimes we get into storms. The storms come up on us. And we wonder, God, what are we going to do? But I know today that if I reach out and I ask God to help me, he'll help me through that storm. But I just got to hold on to him. I got to hold on to that little bit of faith that we're supposed to have as Christian people. And without faith, we have nothing. But God's word said that he give us a measure of faith the size of a grain of a mustard seed. And as the more we read God's word, the more we study God's word, the more our faith begins to grow, and the more we find out that we can do through Jesus Christ. Because without him, I can do nothing. But when the storm comes, I can reach out and I can hold on to him. And I know that I'm going to make it through my storm. Hallelujah. As my hut is, I'm still standing. Wonder how I made it through this storm. I can't boast of any special powers. There's no secret, I just held on. And I held on till the storm was over. I don't claim to be a hero. I don't have all the answers. I held on till the storm was over. Not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong. I just held on. Blessing to call my own. Many times I wondered if I would make it. While I was wondering, I was holding on. And I held on till the storm was over. I don't claim to be a hero. I don't have. Held on till the storm was over. Not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong. I just held on.
I don't claim to be a hero. I don't have all the answers. I held on till the storm was over. Not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong. I just held on. Thankful that I've got somebody to hold on to tonight. I'm so thankful to be a born again Christian tonight. Born again child of God in glory. We had a couple requests that Chris Jarber back here to do. I don't think I'll change or gone, and we got another one.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and fear my grace of relief. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first. Will be forever mine.
Debbie and George. Let's next go with that Mitchell Raider and Faye Raider.
This fellow back behind the camera.
Oh, and the guy back here behind the camera. If I were a gambler, I'd tell you what I would do. I quit my gambling, Lord, and work on the building too. I'm working on a building, I'm working on a building, I'm working on a building.
What would you do?
I quit my drinking, Lord, and work on the building too. I'm working on a building, I'm working on a building, I'm working on a building for my Lord, for my Lord. It all goes building, it all goes building, it all goes building for my Lord, for my Lord.
That's a great way to conclude the singing tonight by Mercy Roadz from Berea, Kentucky. Now remember, they are in the process of getting another new CD made. And if you want to be one of the first to get it, be sure and call them at 859-200-2065. And their church is Rose Hill Church at Mount Vernon, Kentucky. We appreciate them coming and singing tonight and sharing their talents with us. Real quickly, let's see how many of these we can mention. A lady from Powell County of a COPD and on oxygen. This one has physical needs or children needs to be saved. Robert from Hindman, Kentucky, from Pike County. Curtis has cancer. From Madison County, Roger Sr. has health problems. From Madison County, Alicia is having a baby girl in 3 weeks. David from Fayette County is in St. Joe Hospital. Gangrene is in his foot and they're having to remove his leg. Billy Ray from Knott County is on life support and his lungs and kidneys are failing. Deborah for Benjamin from Bourbon County in the hospital since February the 2nd needs healing and salvation. Corey and Tiffany for health and happiness. Mojo from London has been hit by a car and needs prayer tonight. Mary for Blanche from Knott County is in the hospital in Hazard in ICU, and all of them need prayer from Knott County. Grandmother for her granddaughter, and she's had some moles removed and wants to make sure that it's not cancer. Deborah for Harold from Louisville. He's burned very badly and is in a medically induced a coma right now. And Catherine from Pulaski County having tests next week. From Bourbon County, here talks about an individual that's in jail and needs prayer. Isabella from Garrett, Kentucky. Vicki said this is her church. And that's from Powell County. From Montgomery County, Earl and Goldie, they're feeling better tonight than what they've been, so that's good. Ms. Loudon, she's still having some physical needs, and she always waits for Dr. Jesus to come, she says. Mary Ann from Fayette County, for her mother, Mary Ann's mother, which is Nancy Jean. She's 79 today, and also request prayer for a friend that lost his wife today. Anna from Rockcastle for Jerry and James, physical needs there, and this name is withheld, for a member that is addicted to drugs. Rodney from Georgetown for Faye and Jerry. From Letcher County, Crystal. From Carter County, Allen. From Clay County, George. Louisville Hospital, Catherine. From Johnson County, for a son. A brother has called for a sister from Scott County. From Mount Vernon for Mary. Janice has called for Mary and also for Janice needs prayer. For Brother Roy from Tennessee, infection in the body and he's in a nursing home. A mother, children and grandchildren all from the Berea area needs prayer. Anna from Scott County. This one is from a lady in Powell County that is on dialysis, and another one from Clay County, and we have another one or two coming, I think, and this one is for Benny that has called and needs prayer. You know, each need is different, but I'm glad the Lord knows us all and he knows how to minister to us. So please agree with me in prayer right now for all of these needs. Father, in Jesus' name, we know the gospel has gone out in song tonight, and in the word that we read talks about your love. And for those that have never experienced real love, then we ask, Father, that it happen for them tonight. When they start thinking and meditating on you and your goodness, let them feel that true love we were talking about and how strong it is and how wonderful it is and how complete it makes you feel when you feel the love of God in your life. And we ask for healing for those tonight that are feeling rejected and down and kind of like pushed aside. But Lord, we know you've never done this to them. People have, but help them to realize that they do not look at you like they do people, because people are humans, but you do not fail. And so we thank you for your love. We pray for each one of these, Lord, that has called in, and for the salvation, the deliverance that is needed from these drugs, alcohol, and the ones in jail, and just so many needs, Father, represented tonight. And we know that This is no problem for you. You will meet the people as soon as they open up their heart and allow you to, you will minister to them. So we ask for you to do that. We pray that you'll bless our singing guests tonight, continue to keep them safe, heal these that were in that car accident, heal them from any damage, and let them continue to sing for you. And Lord, we thank you because we know tonight will be someone's last night on this earth, and we know that you are right there. If they have accepted you, you're right there to take them home. There's no fear. There's no need to dread because you will never leave them nor forsake them. They can just go to sleep knowing that you have them cradled in your big arms. And we thank you because that we know that heaven is only one breath away for everyone that has accepted you. So tonight, Father, for those that are so near eternity, we ask for a special anointing, special blessing, and a special comfort to be with them in those rooms, in the hospital, in the nursing homes, in their private homes. Lord, they need that comfort that only comes from you. Thank you for your goodness tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we know there's a lot of folks that really need help. And we know some of them maybe listened for the last time tonight. We've had that happen over and over. We had, in the beginning of Christian TV, you know, we had a lot of criticism and enemy fighting. But we had one friend, he did not go to church, but he was a good fighter, physical fighter, and that was the only way he knew to even anything. And so at a certain pool hall in a county nearby, they would gather in and they'd turn on the program at night and they'd watch it. Well, they would be some people, of course, smart off and criticize and so forth. But this one man, he always defended the ministry, even though he was, you know, we did not know him personally. We did not know that he was doing this. We didn't know it was happening. And so he had fought physically to defend the ministry. That was the only way he knew how. But you know, one night when he walked out of that pool hall, somebody gunned him down. But I often think he heard the program that night in the midst of all that was going on. And we do not know, but what he prayed that night, we don't know. Only God knows our heart. And so I just thank the Lord that this gospel can go into all those places that we can't, but the program can and the Holy Spirit can. And so that's what we're dependent on. Let the Lord take care. He said if we lift him up, then he would draw people to himself. And that's what we bank on every single day, is the Lord doing his work after. And so we want to be faithful to do our little bit, but we know that's all in his hands. Well, once again, thanks for our singers tonight, and we pray for them to have a safe trip. But our time is gone, so from all of us, good night, and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy. And it's free. May God bless you.
There's a long line waiting at the hill of Calvary. mercy and grace.